Hey there, it's Bree, and this is my September TBR. So I did this thing last month, but I don't think I really talked about it too much. I decided that when I pick out books that I want to read for my TBRs, I want to be kind of strategic about it. And these will be kind of like a guideline to all of the books that I want to read in September. So I average usually, oh gosh, how many? Like 26-ish books per month. So I only pick for my TBR, I only pick about like 13 or 15, I can't remember how many there are, but I only pick half of that as my, like, not set in stone, but as my September TBR, so that I have room to be a mood reader and just pick up things that come up or that I forgot about or that I just really want to read. But I like to try to stick to my TBR as much as possible, but I use it more as a reference than I do as hard and fast rules. If I finish a book, the first thing that I check, if I don't immediately have another book that I want to read, the first thing that I check is my TBR. And I will look at that and be like, what am I in the mood for reading? And then I'll pick one. And I kind of use my TBR as a way to read books that I maybe forgot about. So I have different categories for every book that's on my TBR. The first category is a category that I just made up like this month. So what I think I'm going to do is start reading all the books that I haven't read yet in my very first bookshelf and go through it like alphabetically. So the very first book that I have in my very first shelf in my library is Misadventures with a Manny. And this one is by Tony Aleo. So that's what I'm going to do every month is I'm just going to go like shelf by shelf and pick up the books I haven't read yet. So going with this one, this is a book that I actually got from my mom. She bought it from, I think, Shameless Book Con. This is an author I've not read before, but I have read books within this series. So this series is kind of one where a bunch of different contemporary romance authors contribute to. Lauren Rose's Misadventures with a College Girl is my all-time favorite, like my favorite book by her and one of my all-time favorite contemporary romances. And I also read The Professor one by Sierra Simone, also really good. So I have high hopes for this one. This one is obviously a Manny romance, which is a male nanny. I think the heroine, her husband left her like and ran away with the nanny. So she hires a male nanny and he is a live-in nanny. And I guess like she has two little boys and they're kind of troublemakers, but he is able to handle them. So excited to read this one. It's nice and short, but hopefully it'll be cute. It has pretty high ratings on Goodreads. And then my next category is a book from my TBR jar. So this one I'm going to pick right now from my fun little TBR star jar. The first time I picked a book from my TBR jar was last month and I had so much trouble opening it, so wish me luck. Let's see. Okay. So each color does represent a different genre or different something, not necessarily a different genre. It represents a different place where I have these books. So every single book in here is a book that I own, but some of them are like in my Audible library, or it's an Audible Escape, or it's a Kindle Unlimited, or whatever. It's on my bookshelf. So I don't remember what yellow represents, and I'm too lazy to look it up. So let's just do this. Let's do some ASMR for you guys here. Oh my God, I still do not remember how to open these. Maybe in like 3 months, I'll figure out an efficient way to open these stars. Good, 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 good. All right, this is, I read this one already. It's The Groom Will Keep His Name in this one. I read this one already. This is one that I had on Libro.fm. So we're just gonna get rid of that one and we are going to pick a new one. I feel like I didn't close my eyes the first time. Purple. I have a lot of purple in here. These might be the books that are on my bookshelf, but I could be wrong. Oh my God. Wait, this one's super tight too. I ripped it. Oh my God, I kind of just want to rip it. Can I rip it? Is it going to ruin everything? Maybe not. I ripped it. Ooh. Is that important? I don't see letters. Okay. All right. All right. We're getting there. What are you? Oh, this is a book from my bookshelf. I think if this is what I think it is. Oh my God, I'm the worst. Okay. I'm ripping it. I ripped it. Okay, so it ended up being The Last Magician. So this is a YA fantasy-ish, maybe? I think there might be time travel in it. Could be completely wrong. I added this to my bookshelf and got it because Hannah from A Clockwork Reader, like a long time ago, read it, and it was already an older book when she read it, and she was singing its praises. I have the first and second book in this series, so I'm excited to read this one. Like I said, I don't know if this is like magical realism, if there's historical, if there's time travel, it's something, but I know that it's YA. And I feel like a lot of people started reading it after she recommended it and they were really liking it. So we'll see if I do. Okay, next category is... Okay, so these are all my family picks. Rory picked for me All the Ever Afters by Danielle Teller. This is the untold story of Cinderella's stepmother. So Rory had picked for me Heartless, which is another villain. I almost said villain romance. No, it's another villain like retelling. And I loved it. So I'm super into villain retellings now. So I'm very excited to read this one. I have not heard very many people talk about this book. So I don't even know what the ratings are for it. All I know is that I love this cover and I'm super into villain stories. So excited to see what this one brings us. Like, especially because at least the Queen of Hearts was interesting. I feel like Cinderella's stepmother was just awful. Also, if you hear the toilet flushing, it's because my daughters like got up and went to the bathroom. So sorry about that. Next is the book that my husband picked, and I almost told him to pick another one because I DNF'd this one recently. It is an ARC. I got it early in one of my book boxes, but I also had the ARC from NetGalley and I DNF'd it because I couldn't get into the story, but I think I want to give it another try because it's not that I didn't like the story, I just couldn't get into it. It is Where Dreams Descend. This is by Janella Angeles. This is a story that has like magicians and it's a woman who is a magician, which is unheard of in the time that this takes place. And it also has some Moulin Rouge vibes. So I love Moulin Rouge. If you didn't know, I love it. Give me all the musical movies and musicals in general. I was enjoying it-ish, but I was also listening to like the text to speech for this one. And I feel like that kind of took away from it. So I think I'm going to physically read this. Also, this book is gorgeous. And he picked it. This was like facing outward. He's been picking the books that face outward on my bookshelf, which I feel like is a little bit of a cop out. But he said that this has been drawing his attention lately. So it's very, very pretty though. So this pile is absolutely gonna fall at some point. Be prepared. All right, and then the book that Violet chose was Muse of Nightmares by Lainey Taylor. This book also faces out on my bookshelf, and I read Strange the Dreamer a long time ago and got this like immediately when it came out, and I got like the signed copy and everything with every intention of reading it immediately, and then I didn't because it takes me forever to read Lainey Taylor books because it's just a lot to absorb. She has beautiful, beautiful prose. It's the type of writing where I have to kind of sit with it for a second to really appreciate it. Oh my God, my hand hurts. I'm gonna switch sides. This isn't even like my bad arm. Okay, so anyway, yeah, this book is the second and last book in the Strange the Dreamer duology. What is Strange the Dreamer about? Funny you should ask because I don't know how to describe it. Like, it's such an interesting storyline. The hero in it, he is like such a cinnamon roll hero. He's such a cinnamon roll hero. Oh my gosh. He's so freaking sweet. She's this like fairy-like creature who controls people's dreams. And she goes into his dream. I think like she's so enthralled by what he's dreaming about and the way his mind works that she kind of falls for him. I think that's right. It's been a while since I read it, but I don't know what this is about because I don't really remember how the first book ended. I'm hoping that this is one of those books that I can go into without really needing to remember what the first book was about. Tell me down below if you read that and if that's the case or if I need to read Strange the Dreamer again. All right, next is I like to pick one book from my Audible Escape TBR, and I ended up picking In Bed with a Highlander. This is by Maya Banks. I have not read anything by Maya Banks before, but I want to. I think she also writes paranormal romance and maybe some other genres, but she also writes historical romance. So this one is the first book in the McCabe trilogy. Obviously, it's a Highlander romance. And in this, it is an arranged marriage between the illegitimate daughter of the king and then a Highland warrior. So it sounds like there's going to be a strong female heroine and a charismatic hero. I'm here for both of those things. Next is a book from my Kindle Unlimited TBR, and I decided to go with Havoc by Autumn Gray. It is time that I read another book by Autumn Gray because I freaking love her. And I decided to pick up Havoc because, first of all, the box set is on KU. The heroine is a divorced model and who moves to Paris, and she has a stalker. I'm excited about this because it takes place in Paris, and I love, like, books like that, especially if that plays a big part in it, I think I'll really like it. And probably going to be emotional. Autumn Gray is really good with chemistry between characters, so that's kind of what I'm expecting going into this. Very excited. Next on my list is a book that I got for free on Kindle, and that is Tough Love by Sky Warren. Sky Warren is an author that I've wanted to read more of, and this one is a dark mafia romance. Mafia romances and motorcycle club romances aren't usually my thing because I'm just not into that, like the type of people that are in those, until I watched 365 D&I, and now I am fascinated by dark mafia romances. Thank you, Massimo. This is a prequel, and it is about a mafia boss's daughter and the son of a mafia foot soldier. I can't talk. All right. Next is an audiobook that I purchased on Audible, and this one is Set by Alexandria House. This one, I believe, is also a prequel. No, it is not. So this is a novella series. It's called Them Boys. That's the name of the series. This is book one. And this is a new-to-me author. I believe she is a Black author as well. So the very first line on the description, I feel like, sums it up quite a bit. It's a chance encounter, and one night of passion leads to a mutually beneficial arrangement for two souls from different worlds. So it sounds like it's an opposites attract type of situation. Next is a book from my Libro FM library, so books that I bought on Libro FM but have not read yet, and I decided to go with A Heart of Blood and Ashes by Mila Vane. This one is because of Jen from the Book Refuge. If you watch my recent reads video, you know that I read a few books because of Jen, so why not throw in another one for September? And it's not fully because of Jen. I had heard of this book, and a lot of people really like this book. I want to say Melissa from She Is an Open Book also liked this one, and a few other people. This is a, I believe, fantasy romance. I think there are dragons involved. The cover doesn't look like something I would love, but it's supposed to have a really, really good romance in it. And that's all I know about it. I don't want to know too much going into it. I really want to go into it blind. And then I have some arcs. Why did I only list one arc? I feel like there are more arcs that I have. Okay, so I might have more than one arc. I have to look it up. But one of them that I'm super excited for is How It All Blew Up by Arvin Ahmadi. This one releases on September 22nd, and it has been compared to Simon versus the Homo Sapiens Agenda because it's a male-male YA romance, maybe? Only in this one, the hero is Muslim. Is that correct? Yes. The main character is Muslim, and he has to come out to his parents, but it's also set in Italy. So like I mentioned about Autumn Gray's book, I'm super into books that are set somewhere where the city itself is a character, and it sounds like that's what this is going to be. And then let me see, I'm gonna look up and see if I have any other arcs because I'm pretty sure I do. Well Played by Jen DeLuca. This is the second book in the series. The first book was, what was the first book? It was Well Met. Well Met, right? Yes. So, and Well Met, I don't know what Well Played is about. I'm going to go into this blind because I really liked Well Met. Well Met was a romance, a contemporary romance that took place within Renfair. And I have like a special place in my heart for Renfair because my best friend and her boyfriend met at Renfair, and they had like this epic romance that like took place in Renfair. I think I'm gonna have her on my channel at some point, and she can talk about her little romance with her Fabio. I call him Fabio. But anyway, I really like the first book in the series, so I'm excited to read this one. This one also releases on September 22nd. I am also planning on reading Goodbye Orchid by Carol Vanderhendy. I can't read my handwriting. But this one releases October 1st, so I do want to read it before it releases so I can tell you guys about what I think about it. I talked more about this one in my book haul because I hauled it recently. The cover is gorgeous. I have it. I own it. I have a physical copy, but I don't have it like in front of me right now, and I'm too lazy to go get it. This one is supposed to be pretty emotional. I think it has a scarred hero in it. I like the whole premise just completely left me, but it's a hero that something traumatic happens, like life-changing happens to him. I think it's like almost workplace romance, like they worked together. I think she was his client or something. And then she ends up obviously becoming much more than that, but it's supposed to be super emotional. And then those are all the arcs that I have to read this month. This coming weekend, I am going to do an arc reading vlog because I'm currently reading an arc and I might still be reading it by this weekend. And I want to read those two books. So I think I'm going to do a reading blog for that. So the next book I want to read is a book that I have on my Scribd TBR, and that is The Secret by Julie Garwood. This one also is kind of because of Jen. Not that she's the one who recommended it to me. It's because I think she is doing a group buddy read for this. Jen has her own Discord for her subscribers, which is awesome, and she does group buddy reads in it, and that's why I read The Beast of Beswick. We did a live show for it, and I would love to join her on the live show if she needs me for The Secret by Julie Garwood, if she does one. So I'm going to read this one. This is loved by a lot of historical romance readers. I've heard a lot of people talk about it and they really like it. I've never read anything by Julie Garwood, but that's not really surprising considering I haven't read a lot of historical romance. I hope you couldn't hear that tapping. I've been shaking my leg, like, I don't know why. Anyway, this one is another Highlander romance. It's a romance between Judith and her father's Scottish barbarian escort who is taking her to her father's land. I believe her father is a laird and she's traveling to go stay with him, and he sends his barbarian of an escort to take her there, and then they end up falling for each other, and it just sounds so good. I love that kind of premise, like where they travel long distances with each other and end up falling for each other. And then next is another, apparently, Beauty and the Beast retelling or reimagining, contemporary though. This is a book from my Hoopla TBR, and that is Beauty and the Bachelor by Naima Simone. This will be my second Naima Simone book. The first one, I think I gave 3 or 4 stars. I can't really remember. This one is a billionaire bachelor romance, which is not normally my thing, but because I want to give this author another try, and because it is, like, I think supposed to be a Beauty and the Beast retelling, I mean, that's what the title would lead me to believe, I want to give it a shot, and I think that I might like it. So it is a romance between Lucas, who is, like, obviously this billionaire, and his rival's daughter. So I think it's like an arranged marriage between him and the daughter. And I think this sounds Kiss Thief-ish, which is also not good because I didn't like that book. I hated it, actually. I gave it 2 or 1 star. I can't remember. She's getting married off to him as, like, I don't know if it's revenge or it's like payment of some sort, but obviously it's going to be hate to love, and we will see. Okay. And then I wanted to read a book that I had purchased on Kindle, and I decided to sort all of the books that I have on my Kindle by, like, the oldest. And one of the oldest books that I purchased 1.5 million years ago was Hopeless by Colleen Hoover. I love Colleen Hoover. I've loved every book that I've read by her so far, except for, well, no, I liked Verity, but I didn't love it. So I'm excited to read this one because I've heard a couple of people say that they really liked it. I think I even heard that it's some people's favorites. This sounds like it's a YA or new adult romance because I think the main character is a teenager. I read the synopsis, and it didn't really make sense. There weren't any, like, certain tropes or anything in it that it really talked about. All I know is that it's probably going to be super emotional because it's Colleen Hoover. And I think both of the characters have, like, troubling pasts. They have, like, some sort of reputation. I'm guessing the girl probably is slut-shamed or something. Colleen Hoover is an author that's, like, an auto-buy author or auto-read author for me, where I don't necessarily have to ever read the synopses of her books because I'm pretty sure they'll like it no matter what it's about. All right, and then last but not least, I wanted to pick a nonfiction book. And due to my absolute love of Hamilton the Revolution, which is the book about, like, the making of the musicals, like a behind the scenes look at it, I already had this on my shelf and I've been wanting to read it since I got it. It is Dear Evan Hansen, Through the Window. So this is similar to that one. It's like a behind the scenes look at the Tony Award winning musical that I have been obsessed with forever, and it's about, like, the original cast. This is a gorgeous book and also weighs 3,000 pounds, but it has, like, the blue sprayed edges and has gorgeous pictures in it. Like, hello. This one obviously is going to be a very quick read, but I'm very excited to get a peek into, like, the background of it. I know a lot about it because I've watched, like, every interview ever that the original cast had and, like, all a bunch of behind the scenes stuff, but I'm interested to actually read this book. And then the very last category, which I think I said this was the last category and I was wrong. The last category is the book that you guys voted that I should read both on Kindle Unlimited and Audible Escape. So let's tally up the votes because I just realized I have not done that yet. So I'm going to do that now. Okay, so I finally tallied up the winners and they won by a landslide. I feel like, well, is it a landslide? 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3. Yeah, they won by a landslide. And that's so funny to me because the past 2 months that I've been doing this, there are specific books that win by like a huge landslide. And I don't really understand why. The two books that won this month for Audible Escape is Headmaster. And this is a book about a headmaster. I think it is a teacher and a headmaster, and it's like takes place at this like gothic boarding school or private school or something. And I think it might be somewhat of a forbidden romance because I'm pretty sure heads of school can't date teachers. That would be like a conflict of interest. So sounds really good. And I've never read anything by this author. And then the other one is Ringmaster. And as Riley said in the comments of that video, she said all the masters. So I'm going to be reading all the masters this month. Ringmaster is a circus romance. It's about a girl who runs away, joins the circus, and the hero is like the ringmaster. I'm visualizing The Greatest Showman in my head right now. But the hero is the ringmaster. I guess he does this trick where he throws knives and she is going to be the one that gets the knives thrown at her. And also there is an age gap. I believe she is 18. I don't know how old he is, but very excited about both of those. I'm so excited for my TBR this month. Can't wait to read all of these books. I'm still working my way through my August TBR, but I've done pretty good. Like, I think I only have one or two books from my August TBR that I still have to read. So yeah, I've been doing good with my TBRs lately. Like, I've actually been wanting to read the books that are on it, even though they are books that not all of them I've chosen for myself, but they're all books that were on my TBR anyway. All right, guys, I think that is it. Thank you so much for watching, and as always, happy reading. Mwah.